Hey everybody, welcome back to Cross the Home. And stuff here. Prepared it. Because we need some money for it. As you're about to see, we are. For the time period that we've got this map, we're not going to need that again. Because this is the end result of silage from all the grass fields. It's as high as a K barn. It's ridiculous. What have we got? We've got F1. Ah, doesn't tell you. It's about 600,000 liters, and considering it takes about 250,000 liters to feed our cows for a year, means our cows are fed for just over 2 years. So we don't have to worry about that anymore. So means we are done with this. So this is off to the shop. It can be somebody else's breadwinner now. So, how is everybody? I hope you're all very well. As ever, I'm very well, thank you for anybody asking. Had a busy few days again at work. Seems a bit of a story of the way things are at the moment. It's like, just being able to get on here whenever I get a chance. I'd rather do live streaming, but when you're getting in it, 11 o'clock at night, and you've got to get something to eat, and you've got to get cleaned up, and it's like, my bad. You don't want to be live streaming, then there's going to be no one about to bloody watch it, so. I'm going to sell, and it's sold. This is where we go from being poor buggers to slightly less poor buggers. We accepted the fact we're never going to use this place on this map, because we can't grow soya. And we can't grow corn, and we can't grow other things that I haven't thought of yet. So, hang on, sorry about this, jump through your garden, F1, that looks like it's got something. Yeah, got loads still. Look at our lovely melons. And growing away. Take it off. And go down to that area. There we are. Right, so we've no need for you at the moment, so jump inside, fire it up. Okay, headlights make no difference on this thing whatsoever. That's great. Oh, put our lights on the back. Yeah, them lights are rubbish. Clean you, put you away. We've done so many things now. Yeah, so after the last episode of driving around, collecting lots of grass and all the stuff, finished going around all over the fields, collecting all of those. And compacted it all down, which took forever. Yeah, that took an age to get all that compacted. I think it was about 2 hours of messing about with tractors trying to get followed. I managed to get all the tractors and the telehandler going in a circuit over the new silage, through the empty bit, and back on, all following each other. So I got like the all from follow me, and then the last one to follow the first one to follow the last one again. So they just kept going around. So I could wander off and get a few other little things sorted, check on some fields. make a cup of tea, that kind of thing, you know. Oh, it's all in there now, and it's all fermenting away. Cows are doing what cows do. We gave them the last little bit of silage out there, we mixed it with a couple of bales. As you can see, we've still got 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 25 bales of 4,000 apiece. Is that 10,000 now? It's 100,000 litres, isn't it? Yeah. 100,000 litres of straw there, of hay there, and we've got another good chunk down by the farmhouse. And then we got 10 straw bales. Do the cows need any of those though? Yeah, they could do a bit of straw. And some power food. Haven't got any more grass though. Did dump a good chunk in there when we were doing the forage harvest. Whoa. Easy tiger. Let me get another couple of these. Come on. An angle, there we go. Ta da! And that is. Yep, that's full. Actually, you could do a damn good wash. Works hard, keeps scooping up all the overflow from the silage bin. Pretty filthy dirty. Let me check our machine as well, see if any of them need some maintenance. Whoa! Oh, that was. Wondered how old that was. Nice little thing to have this. I think pretty solid, but you can chuck a flake about it now. It's more useful, isn't it? Wheel loaded, but it's nice to have a little bit of one. It's just in a stand out nice and calm now. Hands up and strike. There we go. Spikes down, and then up into the workshop. Actually, they have 10 days of domains. Well, we're gonna do it now. Ah, Alt and R. Do you wish to repair? Yes. Then we're good for 12 days. And then we have to get it. Oh, I'm going to stop it first. Oh, it's JCB, I can hear in the background. Then we have to open the cover. And then one of the, somewhere on here, we can service. Or you can only service it at set intervals. Might only be set into those. Well, we're clean and we've done service on it, so we're all good for now. Right. Nice boy. Right. Oh no, we don't want to do that. We want to maintain Alt and R. Yes. We're on 12 days now. No, you do need a wash. Solid. My coat cuts up this one. I'm just getting a bit dark. Oh well, we'll wait until that. Farming news. Where are we going next? Oh, I don't know yet. I mean, we've had in 2 years three failed crops. We failed with the corn, and we failed with. We failed with the soya. Then we planted a winter crop. And that failed before we even got to winter. So, all in all, it's not been entirely successful. Go on. We've never had a winter. We're not going to bother with winter crop now, we know that's going to fall flat in this phase. And we're not going to bother planting anything complicated in the new year. When spring comes round, we're going to stick to wheat and barley, and may plant a field of canola. We'll see. Not exactly in financial difficulty now, but we've got all that solid yard that's going to be able to offload the solid yard stuff. I think we can comfortably go into next year knowing what we're going to be doing. $50. Thank you very much. Oh, I've got to have books. Interactive controls. Jumping up. Speed time, but it was going to be a whole day. And back into the JCB. Now I should have to back into the JCB. Alt and repair. €42. Now, you know how expensive to keep in check, am I? Why don't you do it in plenty of time? That costs nothing. We'll look after all our equipment. Keep it repaired, keep it clean. Use one for something. We've got to put grass cutting equipment away. I have it left here from when I was doing the compacting train. It is. to turn around anyway, so. Right. Nighty night. Everything's off, I think. If not, I don't know what fuel charge we're going to get done with. I swear milk prices have bottomed out as well. $7,000 for milk. At one point we were getting $16,000 for it, so I don't know what's going on with that. Late autumn. $3,000 for. I don't know why we get charged for animal upkeep. It's like we're paying to get all the crops in for, like the hay and stuff for them and the silage, and it's turning around and still charging us. I think we're getting conned somewhere along the line. How's the silage doing? 53%. So. I'm trying to think what we've got to do today. We've got some cultivating to do. So we're going to wait until daylight comes around. Where's our GCB? Right, let's get out of here. We need to wait. I think we've left it down the bottom there. I'm sure I remember seeing it here somewhere. Yep. Try compacting the sides on that to try and remove the ridges, but it really didn't go down well. We've got direct seed there, so we don't need to cultivate, do we? Oh, I don't know where the player's gone. What did I do with my player? I haven't sold him. It's a cultivator, we don't need that, so we'll take that to the store, get a shutter there. Where's the player? Where is it? Great demand by Baywa for potatoes. We don't have any potatoes. We look like a potato farmer. Right, so. In this one. No, that one. It is. Oh, it's over at the top of 14. Somebody said that there. Okay, don't care. Those are the three crops that we're looking at. Although it doesn't look like canola's grown in these parts either. If no one else is growing it, I don't think I'm going to grow it. We'll check the seasons menu in a minute and see what the temperature ranges are for him. Right, so. One's player, the rest are all harvested. And they're all ploughed. So, no ploughing required. Right, so. We can. Don't know if we spread the manure on there, is it going to fertilise it now? Or are we going to have to. Is it going to wipe it out over winter? I am unsure. God, I just said Wiesta. Forest. Oh, forest. Wiesta. Well, wise, sorry. Wise is field, grass, maybe, meadow. Forest. Forest. Anyway, that's not the point. Right, I'm gonna go and sell these. Could be down here. Stop using the keyboard, Stuart. Don't be lazy. Use your pedals and wheel. It's just all too easy to use the keyboard to get stuff done. You're pottering about the yard. Should we invest? Oh, I think we maybe should invest some of our money in another field. Expand our farm. $9,500. So, what's that? What have we got field wise? Eh? Let's have a look. Get rid of that. Where would we like to buy? We've got a couple over this way, we've got a couple over that way. We've got a big, big field. I'd like one without a flipping outcrop of trees in the middle of it, but the more square the better. I think the leaves really, we've got 15, 21, oh, two. Field number two. Round up the field number two. That doesn't look that big. Better sound is four, is it? 14? No? Oh, it is bigger. How much is it? £137,000. Oh, that's cheap then. How much is three then? Because three looks a little bit bigger. £138,000. That's 1.86 hectares. Hectares? I'm not sure. 1.85. Yes. There's a little difference between the two, isn't there? But we can do that though. We've got 11 minis to fertilise the field and it'll get us a bit of a discount. Cruise control, please. It's there for. Allow an air mechanic. You may very well take. Think of it. Just under a minute per pass. Yeah, I only have like 10 passes, so yeah. Time's about right. It's on hard difficulty after all. Thank you. Good news, the wise man once said. Gold Rush the game. We've got a closed beta release date of the 2nd of October. So that is all we need to wait until very soon, about 3 weeks away now, and then it's going to be followed by a full Steam release, not console release yet, full Steam release on the 13th of October, I think it was. So, I do have access to the closed beta, so, all being well, on the 3rd of October, be live from the Klondike, Alaska, or wherever it is. I don't know, Klondike, Canada, or Alaska. We'll be live from Alaska, definitely, as we begin our hunt for riches. I mean, it's got a very short beta period. I don't know how they're expecting to catch all of the little glitches it was bound to be in that short space of time, but they know what they're doing a damn sight better than what I do, so far be it for me to question. As long as the game's not riddled with problems, very few in the way of complaints. Just can't get right. I can't get stuck in, so addictive to play, but with the alpha, or pre-alpha even, you're not having any save game function, which you do have in the beta. It's like you can play and play and play, and then as soon as you walk away from it, you lost it all, it's gone. And it's just so frustrating. This is what it is though. Day still ticking by while I'm doing these times 30. You've got to have got sun flows in the air, no release. It's all like that, it's not going to be cool. As well, and in real life, the chickens are doing very well. Got to finish off frame and all of the netting on the coop, well, the coop they've run today. Now I'm gonna build a gate. I've never built a coop before, built that, never built a run before, built that. Now I'm gonna build a gate, I've never done one of them before. A coop and a run, just sit there. Gate's gotta move, it's gotta function. Which could be interesting. See how it does. Come on. One more pass after this maybe. Might let us get it done. Yep, no eggs yet either. Two of them are ready any day now. The one's beat you. We've got a little time on that one. Got to first of all convince them that they don't sleep in the nest boxes. Sleep on roofs, like little wooden beams that are above the floor. They sit on them and go to sleep. But these three decided they want to sit in the nesting boxes where they're only supposed to go with their eggs. So they've got no eggs, so they should get the bloody hell out of them. May have to block them off until they're sleeping on the roofs properly. Come on. There we go. Wow, look at all the money they've given us. He wants to play it now. 40 minutes to play the field, and he's going to give us $6,000. You've got no chance. Well, what I might do is I might buy it off you next year. I'll do the fertiliser and stuff on next year and then buy it off you for the cheap. But in fact, we might do that. I might try and get a couple of fields next summer after he's planted them. Let him plant them up, let him him pay for the fertiliser and we'll fertilise it and we get a discount. Playing the system a bit, but if we get our money's worth out of it at the end, it's worthwhile. So, what have we left to do? Tractors are all away, you're away. So everything's been serviced. You've got to come back to the farm. We're all done at the shop for now. I think I want to buy a bigger muck spreader. I haven't decided. Build a plow, but I'll get it out of the field. Next time. But for now, I'd like to thank you all for joining me. As always, politely requested, if you do like what you've seen, please like and subscribe to my channel. If you've got any input on what you think I should be doing, shouldn't be doing, or would like me to try, anything like that, then drop it in the comments. I do read them all and I'm grateful of any input. At the end of the day, it's like I'm playing this game for enjoyment, but if it's something that you guys think would be more enjoyable or better to watch, then go for it. Let's hear your suggestions. Until then, I'll see you in a live stream very soon. Bye-bye.